The aim of the whole archive is to maintain a national collection, growing national collection, of films of both artistic and historic importance, so that they can be used for future research and future enjoyment.
77, take 3.
This is the final take. The scene has been rehearsed and worked on until it's completely right.
The interesting thing about the use of images is that they're often drawn up out of something in the past, some experience which stimulated a strong emotional response.
Whenever you go down the roads in Britain, you travel not in three dimensions, but in four. The fourth dimension is the past.
And as we move to and fro in this fourth dimension, we see not only landscape, but the economic, political, and social forces at work behind the landscape, shaping it, forever changing it, but leaving here and there the record and the mark.
To begin here,
we spent this evening showing the children an old film of mine, taken at the beginning of the war, 5 years back.
This, of course. How could you?
But you were part of the war even before you were born.
We were fighting for you.
To be the new Elizabethans.
Nine o'clock, and time for Housewives' Choice, introduced for today and the next 2 weeks by John Slater.
Hello, good morning, and a nice bright morning it is.
On a ward in St. Thomas's Hospital, two baby girls were named Festival, and a boy was called Skylar. Poor sod.
Let's start the day right with a nice bright tune for Mrs. Elsie Allen of 65 Fitzroy Road, London, NW1, who says that she would like me to play a tune for her sister Mabel, who is in hospital. A gay tune, she says, that will cheer her up and cheer up all the other people who similarly can't get about very much.
of the 20th century.
London is a city of secret places, of unexpected country lanes and hidden gardens.
No longer post-war, but pre-something else. No one knew what, but we couldn't wait to find out.
What sort of future do you think we're heading for? The year 2000 AD, say, mystic date, but it's only 32 years away.
London watermen from Blackfriars to regular ply, and he feathered his oars with such skill and dexterity, pleasing each maid and delighting each eye. And he sang so sweet, he sang so merry, the couples all jostled to hire his wherry, and he became known as the young lover's fairy, but he could not find a true love of his own.
It was a trick I mastered early on. Take courage, hold the door open, come in last, and slope off early. The brief medicinal illusion of gin. Sound of the jukebox. The ritual of the second round. On the river. You could chuck it all in and sail away anytime you want to. The sterns of the ships beckon us on board. Helsinki, Bremen, Toronto, Leningrad, Las Palmas. Or you could just get another rounding.
Oh, Now, the British Railways Board, under the chairmanship of Dr. Richard Peaching, have completed the investigations they were asked to make and published their proposals.
In all our planning, we haven't forgotten that railways are there to serve people. We haven't forgotten the human side, nor have we forgotten the old British pride in railways.
Railways are an English invention. They started in Britain. They were the first railways in the world. The London to Birmingham railway was the first trunk railway in the world. It had in front of it a Doric portico designed by Philip Hardwick. A magnificent great thing.
Flowers of these first spring days seem to have fallen from frost-bright winter skies. White, gold, and yellow. Anemone, celandine, and primrose.
The city is at its most vivid when you're young. The tired English structure started breaking up. Nothing seemed fixed anymore. All the roles were blurring. Enforced informality became all the rage.
I believe recently in the newspapers there was something about some Texan who said, I'd break my young son's head if I saw him wearing this merchandise. If his young son wears this merchandise, we'll be wearing it next year anyway, because it's young people who are setting the trend and what they say goes.
Song to the Rolling Stones. They gave it back.
This is what England means to me. Some fish and chips and cups of tea. And if you're strolling up and down, you can get a pint of brown. But if you're thirsty after three, there is where it disagrees. It is the English hospitality to offer a cup of tea.
The policeman is a friend of the people.
and he knows that they will always turn to him without fear or restraint in their time of need.
The past is always with us. But who wants to live in an antique shop? Money no longer chinks. It crackles like a forest fire.
What you do, it's the way that you do it.
But how many of us use our bodies correctly? Just look at that bent back and straight leg.
I think this vast trek of pioneering women is on the whole a mistake. Think of the work they do. Are they composing the great symphonies, painting the great pictures, making the great discoveries, ruling the great countries? Of course they're not. They never did. They're acting as drudges for the men.
I would like to be a nurse.
I'd like to be a dress designer.
I'd like to be a teacher.
I'd like to be a pilot.
I'd like to be a private detective like Dick Barton.
This is where they return at the end of the day's work, to be cleaned and serviced, made ready for the next day.
The great hall with its shops, restaurants, and super loos is spacious, clean, efficient.
The illusion that you're still in the country, I think, is ludicrous. You're not. You're in the heart of London, in the great park. I got one of the greatest architectural thrills of my life when I looked at New York from Central Park, especially at nighttime. This extraordinary romantic skyline with the great skyscrapers, and as the sun was setting, you know, the eyes opened up. Lights went on. Felt that these were living things, you know, waking up. Oh, beautiful, very romantic.
birds cry to reclaim London for the country. A forest of concrete and glass. An issue of maintenance rather than design. City, the radiant city. We would build towers, no less. In our plastic Macs, even the rain seemed modern. Dial 01 if you're outside London. When would I ever be outside London? Hop to Southwark, ambassador to Paddington. Look right, look left, look right again.
Anxiety, tension, anger, fear, hate. Railways relax things.
Driving ceaselessly down concrete roads to unknown destinations. Savoy Circus, Gillette Sands, the Sun and Sands roundabout, the Hanger Lane gyratory system. Every time I look at London, it slips into a different pattern. Nothing like a picture is ever formed. Continually fluctuating and flickering, new views always opening up. By day, there were no nameplates to be seen, but after dark, they'd mysteriously appear. Miss Bettina. Miss Lola. Miss Gina. All French models. If you have the blues in the night, ring and walk up, the sign said. The bell was usually broken. And peas, the staple ingredients in Len Dayton's action cookbook. Trying to get a drink at the Ad Lib, trying to get a table at the Ivy. Prosperity creates its own breadlines. Pancakes and fritters say the bells of St. Peter's. Less protein, says Stanley Green. Presents Bosco Holliday's troupe in Tropicana. In the early morning, the city is at its best. Washed fresh by mist and municipal cleaning vans. Still anticipating the onslaught of commuters. And another day.
It was a wonderful day when I got up in the morning. The sun was shining. And suddenly we heard cheers. We thought, you know, goodness, what's this? And into the sight came a dust cart. Of course, everybody was madly waving and shouting and screaming. We all settled down, had ice lollies and chatted for a while, but after about half an hour of this, we were all getting a bit restless.
Early in the morning, near his luxury home, Mickey Most goes on his regular morning training run, shaking off the stresses and strains which come with the glamour of his lifestyle.
Why didn't you lock the records in the boot?
I saw you from across the street, called to your friends. I haven't seen you smile a week. I know something's wrong. I went and bought another book. I'll lend it to you. Maybe we should get some food.
Thinks that the brain, a biological computer, comes offline while we're asleep. And then the programs which control our minds are brought up to date, the events of the day classified and stored. Normally, we wouldn't know this was happening because we're asleep. But if we're disturbed, our conscious mind will catch the data being run through, and that will be a dream. And it'll appear to be contradictory and odd, because the conscious mind is trying to make sense of the jumble of material being classified.
This is the morning of another day, and you kiss another dream away. Ready or not, you never say the things you should.
Two.
got any idea what the population of London is?
About 7,000.
On a winter's afternoon, every street in London can become mysterious. People suddenly appear like a flock of shadows. Seasons are measured out by train timetables and pools coupons. You see the shops through a veil. The air smells of coal smoke, damp wool, and boiled cabbage.
And maps foretell tomorrow's voyages.
How will we live as we slip into the 21st century? We'll pick out children with high mathematical ability and give them special training and help to control the computers, which will be the basis for progress.
Thank you.
three ways of displaying the condition of the heart.
Feels love for their fellow man on the northern line at 8 a.m. Not me. It's a miracle that London works at all. The whole thing is implausible. Bullet. Rosemary's baby. Georgian, Gulliver, Headquarters, Hogarth. Galleries remind us that art isn't a small, remote compartment of the human experience, like croquet or spider watching. The imagination can be explosive. Living in cities is an art in itself.
Trained, ready for work. Trained for a job that is worthwhile, responsible. A job that is important, and not just to yourself.
The system is archaic and odd and enduring. You don't try to rationalize a historical continuity that stretches from Plantagenet kings to Victorian politicians.
The salary of a member is a modest one on which to support himself and a family, and most MPs feel that in any event, a job outside politics enables them to keep close contact with society as a whole, with people whose interests the parliamentary system is designed to serve.
Citizen in England, the Prime Minister, lives like a professional man in a plain house on the side of a narrow cul-de-sac.
Elgar, Empress, Fitzroy, Fremantle, Galleon. Gravesend, 3 a.m. London Bridge, 4. Battersea Bridge, 4:30. Low tide at 12. Brunswick Foreshore, Canada Dock, East India Dock. The Empire may have gone, but you wouldn't know it walking along the Thames. Surrey Docks is where the number one bus terminates. Is that where London begins? Right.
Collected buildings and associations that make it a tourist's paradise.
Humanity, quality, scale. The three first principles of an architect's work.
Buildings aren't just boxes with four walls and a lid. They're as complex as the lives we lead. There are no fixed rules. They must be practical and pleasant. And nowadays, of course, they mustn't cost too much. That's all.
Technology expands and shrinks your dreams. Bent coins get stuck in chocolate machines. Disillusion is a vital part of the process of dreaming.
Just a few of the places you might see if you came to visit London.
Every day, a different puzzle. Today, graffiti, an eight-letter word meaning inscriptions or drawings upon walls, preferably in public places, and preferably without getting caught.
Thank you.
Clarifoil, Emitex, Bowie at Trident, the pistols at Regent Sound. The studio names sounded majestic. Or like fighter planes.
Well, now for some non-pop music. Try this.
Of another major war might well reach the limits of imagination. Fortunately for all of us, this is a fictional film.
The world in which the city grew up has changed almost out of recognition. More than ever, it now exists by flair, integrity, and a fund of worldwide confidence.
The city is founded on trust and confidence.
Beneath the pavement, there could be the beach. But beyond the city, what? The jetty? Some reclaimed marsh and an oil refinery? A beach hut, maybe.
There's life everywhere, and the tracks we make are shared and crossed by the paths of others who know this world better than we do.
Thank you. came back the other day. Nothing had changed.
We spent this evening showing the children an old film of mine.